against the Invisible Champions. We are finally into Champion Select, ladies and gentlemen. We'll see if we get ourselves an Evelyn so we can blabber about it a little bit more throughout the game. LeBlanc and that Callista Kobe, like you said, picked or banned, and it will be first banned by Team 8.
There's plenty of more we could babble on about.
So many.
Eve. But, yeah, there's the Callista ban expected. Wow, actually didn't think it would come first ban, but they probably knew they weren't giving away anything with that. Off the board here for Piglet this time around. As far as Team Liquid, just strong champions down the line. Slushy had already a couple of games where he carried on LeBlanc and just going to target basically high priority champions in each lane here, tagging top and mid. Same thing goes for AD carry and jungle. These are basically just the super strong champions of those roles. So nothing really given away by either team.
Nope.
As far as what team strategy they're going for so far.
Hecarim banned as well as Urgot. Had a little Hecarim yesterday up in the top lane from Gamsu, as well as some of that Urgot coming out. Not today, though. Gragas will be banned. The early game jungle gets hit a little bit. We'll see if Rek'Sai gets taken out as well. So nobody gets a jungler. And he does. Dominate will not get that. Favorite of Porpoise as well.
Okay, so there are still some strong Cinder Hulk options left up there. Nunu, of course.
It's the crowd shouting Gnar.
They want Quas to have another repeat performance. It definitely was noteworthy. Cali Trolls definitely has a very flexible champion pool. Mm-hmm. But I don't know how much, if any, he's practiced the Yasuo Gnar matchup, which the longer you look at it, just looks better and better. So I don't know if
see teams, yesterday.
Yeah, if this wrinkle that has emerged causes teams to not continue to early pick Gnar.
It was definitely the weight and the consideration. They chose not to show too much with the Thresh pick, but they do get a special something that he wants.
Yep, pretty safe pickup down there.
Yeah.
Gonna have the Lantern ability also for the Expecial Porpoise or Expecial Dominate combo when they go to try and get Vision down. Dominate also has recently been opting more towards the farm and counter gank style of jungle rather than the more risky early gank level 3 package jungling, because you can get a large reward early on if you get one of those successful early ganks and really set the tone for one of your lanes. However, we've seen several times in a couple games yesterday where the junglers that went for the early ganks unsuccessful and then were consequently behind a bit in farm, down a level. Every level does count for jungling.
Yep.
And there is the Sejuani, another one of the Cinder Hulk junglers still left on the board, just fine.
Good bit of beef there picked up already by Team 8. See what they can do with that.
Yep, strong team fighting for them. They've got plenty of engage tools already for the squad. We'll probably complete a Righteous Glory on one of the two as well. So Team 8 already able to force fights. Let's see what Team Liquid will not answer with. If they want to actually double down on a team fighting composition and try and out team fight them. Mm-hmm. Or if they would try and opt with a split push here, try and get Quas to that sort of split pushing Jax level that we've seen from him before. It's been a while though. There's the other Cinder Hulk.
Ah, would that be in Azir as well if this Nunu comes in? I wouldn't want to show, but maybe pick it up already. The Nunu is being hovered. You were talking a little bit about junglers making scary moves early. We did see a lot of yesterday's games become a team's advantage out of the mid-game fights.
Oh, yeah. Something we also saw yesterday was a Nunu team lose 5 dragons in a row. That's something you don't see very often. Dominate, always got to keep this in mind. Whenever he plays Nunu, this guy likes to go very early dragons,
right,
and barons, not just dragons. So keep your eye on Piglet's build as well. Either there's a top laner or an AD carry that builds Blade of the Ruined King, Dominate will go for an early Baron, try and sneak it from you. So keep your vision up in that area of the map. And then even earlier on, going to have to watch those dragons so they don't get out of control. Hovering over a Varus, I would actually love to get one of the Varus mid picks in North America. You know, we keep seeing it in Korea, and you see it in Europe. But the early power spike of the Poke champion. Not going to happen.
Not going to happen. The Aurelia and the Graves picked up, however. Maple Street going back to that Graves pickup he loved oh so much at the beginning of the spring split. And Galitrol says Aurelia.
Yep. Just more team fight AD carry here. Yeah. AoE to go with their AoE. Aurelia, though, Galitrol's, this is a champion that was banned against him for so long. Last split. Mm-hmm. Almost every game for Team 8, Galitrol's Aurelia was banned.
They're going double AD.
And now he's going to take it into the Rumble. Rumble doesn't really have too many bad matchups, doesn't really have any that he loses very heavily. So pretty much all of them are definitely easily swayed by jungle or intervention. See if Cali can manage his health well. It's always the thing with Aurelia to try and get just low enough to grab your stun before chugging your potions and going offensive.
Making that Azir wall a little bit more possibly, or locking down the champions that would be diving in on you with a Gaze. Looks like they'll choose the Cassio and the Sivir, a little bit of engage or disengage if they want really throughout this fight.
Yeah, more team fight. So it looks like they've decided to call Team 8 on their team fighting strategy.
Yeah.
Both teams going to go with a lot of AoE. Significant zone control for both squads at the moment right now, actually. Team Liquid with a slight advantage in that area. I'm going to go ahead
and say it's not Rammus in mid.
So the Azir pickup actually looks pretty good right now if Slushi has put in time.
You got a lot of time to fight in the back line with that front. That's for sure. Maybe an equalizer would give him trouble, but it looks like they're going to go with Vlad in the mid lane. Not something we've really seen too much of. We only had a day of play, but we didn't really see it too much at the end as well. It was only picked a few times.
Yeah.
Still, however, works quite well. Scales quite well.
Vlad, definitely very common for the mid lane. Really sustained beast.
Yeah.
The early levels could be where he loses his ground. Cassiopeia, very high damage output. Just pure DPS can definitely out-DPS Vlad. So anytime that Phoenix challenges and feels like he has enough map pressure to push up in the lane and go aggressive, Slushi will have to respect it early on. Just trying to farm up and sustain until he can get to that point.
Right.
With where he's got low enough cooldown for his transfusions.
Get back to that level 9 and then he can fight a little bit. Still becomes very difficult. Going to be a great game. A lot of AoE stoppage coming from the junglers here. You got a Nunu on one side for Dominate, Sejuani on the other. So these fights could change real quick once they start. And like you said, Kobe, both teams bringing a fight composition to the table. Peter and Matt, coach respectively for Liquid and teammate, shaking hands before they head to the back and leave it up to the players, because that's all there is now. The teams are loading into the game, so tell us who you think will take the W. Tweet hashtag TLWin or hashtag T8Win to at LOL Esports. We'll be tallying those up throughout the game. Interesting to see this. Maple Street back on Graves. These are going to be some explosive fights. And we are going to be onto the Rift in just a second. Second day of the summer split here in the North American LCS. And we are ready for the first game of the day.
I am very excited for these top laners. Let's see if we go into standard lanes, because both Cali and Kwas, just as players, love to be in the position to carry a mm-hmm. game. They are now on champions that give them the tools to carry the game.
It's almost like,
see if they can pull it off.
The meta shifting in a way where they can be more and more free with their picks up top as well. It's going to be an interesting split. And
yeah.
This game will show us a little bit of that.
With the prevalence of all these tanks coming from the jungle as well as from the support role, top laners mm-hmm. actually trending back towards DPS options. Cali going to get the first slap.
He can't even keep the Flame Spitter in range.
He's oh! Trinket Ward dropped. That is an extra resource that he will not have. Hey, that's a hard one to pull off,
that
actually.
It is. Well placed.
Talk about the mechanics of trying to get Trinket's wards over to that brush.
That was, like, on point.
I think he just did that to show Cali that he could. It's actually really difficult. You have to get it right on the other edge. If it's not over 50% over the wall, it'll bounce back to the wrong position.
You make it sound so easy. It's not that easy.
It's really not.
All right, back to the mid lane. Slushy's showing off a little bit on his soapbox there as he dances around. Wards all up and down the river, though. Looks like nobody's really gotten any deep, but we will get these lanes matched up. Get a lot of action out of the mid lane.
It's easy with regular wards, Rip, because you can place them further. But trinket wards, that is impressive.
All right, so
just have top side jungle starts for both junglers. So that means that both of the bottom lanes will start off with the early experience. Let's see how quickly they can do this, because the Krugs generally take a little bit longer. And sometimes your bottom lane will miss out on an extra melee minion. Looks like they were able to finish it just in time. They'll be a bit late here, sharing experience for both squads. Both of them will know, though. And he got both melees from Piglet. Nope. Dead even here for the bottom lanes, except that Piglet tanked a little bit more.
Yep. Should be able to get it back with a tad bit of lifesteal there.
Oh, wait, did
Xpecial grab the big one, so he two'd first. I thought it was going to be the hook into lane, but a little too much crowd control and burst coming from the first shots of Maple Street and Dodo. They can't act on it too quickly.
Yeah. Being down the level with the minions pushing against them, that hook means nothing except increases his accuracy stat.
That's a nice grab on the boomerang there. Didn't lose any to that last caster minion. So Piglet, even though he had to stay back, still picking up most of these minions and still has some of that wave. So he's not really that far behind, just hasn't picked him up yet. Top lane, Cali Trolls and Quas are going a bit aggressive on each other, as you see the HP there. But hesitate now as the minion wave gets just a little bit bigger.
Dominate as well. Both junglers ending on the bottom side. Nunu should be able to get the crab if there is a fight over crab. Nunu has...
Oh, so hard to last hit of the turret with him.
Advantage there. Yeah, he's going to get constantly shoved in. As we said earlier, Cassiopeia has control of the lane. Mm-hmm. Also, I like what Phoenix is doing. You know, he trinket wards the top side, hovers on the top side.
Oh, Porpoise in does not decide to flash to connect that assault. And it looks like they're just pushed off a little bit. Nothing too big used for the gank there. Xpecial's flash is down, though.
And that's not too bad for a Thresh Sivir lane, especially since they're already pushed in. Xpecial can just play behind Piglet now, and they can rely on both Spell Shield and Lantern. Piglet there with some good reactions, predicting a Buckshot, able to get the mana back. But another early gank. This is the second time that a 3.5 minute gank has been targeted at the bottom lane of Team Liquid.
Yeah.
This time around, it does not cost them because they were... actually letting themselves be shoved to the turret.
Yeah. A little different of a situation for him on that one. Quas is overheated, and Cali Trolls walks away. Or not overheated, but in that extra damage area for his heat bar. Cali Trolls is trying to work that perfectly. Now he overheats as they go back and forth in this top lane. The vote heavily favored for Team Liquid here. We'll see if that continues to work. Definitely an established team as they place third in the last split.
Yeah.
And Dominate says, mine. Thank you very much.
It's gross watching people eat in front of your face, and it leaves his mouth open.
Especially if they make noise, he just like slobbers on it, so it's weird. It's bad.
Nothing that you can do as an enemy jungler except for watch him take your camp. So Dominate gonna counter jungle both the large raptor as well as the Krugs away from Porpoise. Try and deny Porpoise that early level 6 on Sejuani, keep his experience down. Also sometimes it forces him, forces the Sejuani to go for a more risky early play because there's not enough of his jungle to farm.
So Piglet's definitely starting to fall a little bit behind in CS. That level 1-2 that they had, he's never really gained that HP back that he fully took from the Krugs.
Yep.
Maple Street, Porpoise, and Dodo definitely working that effectively. All of these dredge lines have hit nicely, and Piglet's forced to take a bit of damage. We're hoping he can probably get one of these out for a spell shield soon.
Yeah, and look at the positioning here, too. Even without the engage, Dodo moves up to the side to try and threaten Piglet and make him think twice about these. Ooh, CS. Good pink ward here from Team Liquid, and Dominate is in the area.
I think Porpoise may have done this just at the right time.
Teleport's
not enough
ready
on Piglet. They're getting hit up. Teleport already coming in from Quas in the top lane. Does he get stopped? He does get stopped. That's a dive in by Cali Trolls. The fight's just in the bottom now with the guys that are here. Nobody else to enter this one. Piglet still somehow living as they micro each other in and out to take that damage coming in from teammate.
On the chase.
Oh, the ultimate in the pool, the troll pool. So Lucci's alive, but he is definitely taking a lot of hits. 55 to 30 in that lane.
Yeah, it's going to be hard for him to see us at the turret right now because he's so low, and Phoenix does have Ignite on the Cassiopeia. Has to respect the Ignite summoner spell here from Phoenix, and Phoenix able to deny him further.
Oh, geez. It's just, where do you want CS? You want to move up? He gets a few off the back end there. At least he's getting the melees. The casters should be able to make it to him. And Piglet is still kind of holding on here by a thread in this lane.
Yeah, all of these little things that Team Liquid are doing during the laning phase, earning them a significant gold lead
yep.
without an objective taken. Teleport advantage, though, is really the big consequence of all of that action down bottom. And it's going to be up to Callie to make something happen with that teleport discrepancy.
Board games. It's like Maple Street may have a final back here, unless he decides to stay. Emo Plague onto Phoenix. There's a flash. Stretch line hits. That's going to be Porpoise. Still has charge to pop him if he needs it. And they nicely get that over to Slushy for first blood. 7.5 in.
There's got to be some miscommunication right there. When the lane, see, the bottom lane knew that the Nautilus was roaming because the bottom lane went aggressive. You saw them go extremely aggressive onto
right.
Maple Street to try and punish the roaming Nautilus. But they didn't tell Phoenix that the Nautilus was roaming, it looks like. And he gets collapsed on. Everybody converges mid. First blood for Team 8. And that brings them just back to almost even in gold because of how much work Team Liquid were previously doing in the laning phase.
And you can see Xpecial kind of taking action now. He puts a forward ward over by the blue. That's a good grab and could easily be a kill if they got the last few hits. The dash out from Maple Street. He could have flashed in the end. Team Liquid does not tunnel on the kill, seeing Dodo there. Good choice to stay back. It's just Piglet trying to pick up this CS now and get back in. Not too far behind.
The great equalizers, Riv. Usually it's the jungler. This time it was the support as well as top laner going for the gank. But that's what keeps these matchups in check. The matchups where, yes, Cassiopeia should have a huge advantage over Vladimir early, should bully him. You have to expose yourself by going up in lane and either ward or have better communication so that you don't get punished for that positioning.
Yeah. It's almost one of the things you're not expecting, right? Is your lane's going so good, it's going so good, and then somehow three people are in your lane and you don't have that winning matchup anymore. He's still doing all right, pushing Slushy back into his turret.
Speaking of equalizers,
equalizer,
does he get all the minions?
Pretty close. He might have
missed. I don't think he missed a cannon there. That's heartbreaking.
Scumbag turret.
That's all that top laners live for in the early game. Get that cannon.
But you always miss it for some reason. Oh, Special misses that one. Wouldn't have gone to anybody else with the relic. Here comes Piglet back into lane. So now we have BF sword to BF sword. More damage here for Piglet actually in the longsword before he decides to go for boots. Really relying on that ultimate if there's any type of engage.
Dominate here, timing the second blue buff spawn a little bit slow. Doesn't look like he's going to be able to punish Porpoise as he heads down bottom. But that's where his head's at, obviously, with the Nunu counter jungling, number one priority. Now he'll know the third spawn of the blue buff, though. Obviously, it's not that big of a deal for teammate, but it would be nice for Liquid to have both blue buffs. If you get one on Sivir and Cassiopeia, your wave clear is insane, your shoving potential is ridiculous, and you can melt neutral objectives. Cassiopeia, as we said, one of the highest pure DPS mages in the game. If they're able to chain blue buffs for her, not only do they have that, but they also have a Nunu. So that would pretty much guarantee a lot of neutral objective power for Team Liquid.
Taking over that title of from Ryze as the machine gun mage, at least if somebody's poisoned. Level 8's going for a do-si-do here in the top lane. Transcendent Blades taking Quas down to about 75% HP, but it doesn't look like he has to be too afraid of the engage here with the Kali trolls. Should be a back for him on that clear. We'll see if he gets closer to his Triforce with a Sheen.
And Quas has done a really good job. Kali Trolls has got a lot more assistance from his team in the top lane. Quas has backed off accordingly each time, has not died, has not lost too much health on his turret, and done pretty much exactly what you expect from the top laner, receiving that much attention.
You see a little bit of love from Dominate on the dragon. Actually was able to see what Porpoise knew, where their wards were also. was setting down his own, but Porpoise, having vision of that, makes his way back over and makes sure Dominate does not get that freely. Possibly having something here in the bottom lane. Slowly waiting it. Teammates, maybe like second or third gank down here. At least making sure that Dominate isn't here. It looks like what Porpoise is doing.
Yeah. Dominate has been able to utilize Nunu efficiently. Mm-hmm. You know, got that CS lead, has been able to counter jungle. Has a slight gold lead on Porpoise. Actually a fairly decent, almost 500 gold there for Dominate over Porpoise. All that Porpoise is really looking for is that level 6 though on the early game. Have a high impact gank. Very hard to pull that off against a Sivir Thresh bottom lane though, so that's not really a target. The solo lanes, Vladimir does not do much for setting up ganks. So it would kind of have to be focused on Kwass. And Kwass has been playing, as we said, very, very cautiously. Done a good job absorbing attention. So there haven't been very many good options for Porpoise. Now he is hovering, once again, on the top side. See if he can make anything happen here. Kwass, though, just replenishing his wards.
Replenishing wards. Seemed like he's trying to get to those Sorc boots as well so they can get something down at this dragon. A few grabs in the bottom lane. Both teams just seem to be playing quite safe here, or at least dancing around each other well. They've gone for the engages, but both are able to disengage before too much trouble comes.
Wow. Slushy, because he is up against a painful mid lane, has rushed the Spirit Visage on Vladimir, which is a good item for Vladimir, but not necessarily...
you still get a little AP.
With the early rush. The you get a little AP out of your passive. Due to the health stacking. And it does turn him into the sustained monster really early. So if the game just continues as farming, as is, then a good early buy for the rush there, just because he'll be able to hold some pressure in the mid lane. He cannot, teammate cannot afford to lose control of the mid. Dominate constantly moving back and forth around mid to keep up the vision pressure, because that's really where Team Liquid have a lot of kill pressure, the Cassiopeia lane. Now he's completed the Abyssal Scepter. So magic resist on both mid laners, and it'll probably just be a lot of farming.
Slushy has to keep an eye on whether the fact of Phoenix or Especials Ignite is up as well, because that'll just kind of take him out of the game real quick.
Boss as his ultimate.
A necessary ult from Porpoise there to get out of that situation. And it looks like teammate lost a little bit of ground there. Liquid tried to capitalize, but able to recuperate.
They may signal for Dragon here. Now, nobody got killed, but they burned several summoners, plus the ultimate from Sejuani. So Vladimir goes down, Sejuani flash and ult both down, plus low health. And as we said, Cassiopeia plus Nunu, Dragon is trivial.
Very interesting. Kwass has the Merc treads on him this game, but he's still coming down from the top lane. Teleports up. He's going to go for the long walk, though, and it looks like Team Liquid is just going to get this one out of pure vision coverage.
Honestly, Sejuani with no flash, no ultimate, and only a Cinder Hulk adds little to nothing to this fight. So zero pressure coming from that. They'll just continue to farm. Teammate make the right call. They lost too much on those small skirmishes, and they lose to Dragon for it.
Kwass teleports back to top, which is why he ran down quickly, stopping Kali Trolls from negating that farm and trying to proxy it out, making sure Kwass loses a lot, but he has gotten pretty much all of it. With a few of his back and forth, or at least the back and forth in that lane, 136 to 110 between Aurelia. So Kali Trolls doing pretty good. We'll see if the shot calling from him later can still be on par and keep them in this game. 155 to 120 is kind of where that deficit is made up in the mid lane CS. Phoenix is just going pretty hard right now on Slushy and has not given up. Here comes the blue buff.
Since Kali is going, you know, he's got the Trinity Force rush. He's a very strong split pushing threat, and he does have the teleport advantage. So Team 8 at this point actually want to keep Kali isolated. They don't really want to have him group up. If they can keep him isolated in a side lane, pushing with his teleport for as long as he can, and have the rest of the team stall, they can slowly gain advantages on the side lanes. Because Aurelia, even Aurelia, when they do group up in the 5 versus 5 here, has to deal with Nunu zone control, giant equalizer from Kwass, and then there's the counter engage of a Cassiopeia and Thresh, both with the box. and the Petrifying Gaze. So would be able to get a lot more advantage if he can stay isolated up there.
And they have the wards for it, too. Even Callie's placing another one for himself. But he's got three right across that line to keep him safe up there and on an island. All he wants. Bottom lane getting a bit of focus here. Going to see Porpus run in to dominate. They're on the either side of the wall.
They want to make a play with the teleport advantage, it looks like, and turn it into a 4 versus 3. Dominate, though, protecting his jungle well. He's constantly kept up the outer ring of vision. So he's got an early alert system and not giving up any territory on their side of the map. Very calm farming game from both these really team-fighting-oriented squads.
And has prevented letting all five dragons go to the team as Nunu. So it's good. Got first dragon, already prevented. Going on 18 minutes into this, Cali Trolls looking to get a bit of aggression on as he sees Kwass just about to overheat. Very well played there. Only knew he was going to take a bit of damage to trade back and keeps those little edges in lane. Slushy here again, meeting three. It's a crowd. He's got his own other two in the bottom, clearing out a pink ward. So both teams privy to the knowledge. Transcendent Blades almost taken down Kwass, and he blows the flash as well. That teleports down, so he's not able to get back here.
Yep. Exactly as expected for Cali. He's able to get the isolation he wants. 1 versus 1. Trinity Force versus the Rumble. Boom, yeah. Gets the kill. And he got the flash out of Kwass. So that's going to be either the turret going down or a significant amount of damage on the turret. With Trinity Force procs as well, he might even be able to just take it off that single kill.
Yeah,
so
he's going to
big pickup there for Team 8. Cali Trolls making that Aurelia count.
Wow.
Showing why it was banned against him so often last split.
Very true.
Oh,
Piglet, close to getting hit. Wait a minute, Lantern all the way out. The Thresh Express, a little bit of depth charge on the way for taxes. And they're able to go back to the turret here. It may just go down. They don't have really any cavalry, but Kwass, the teleport as well, just above from Cali Trolls. This could be an extended fight here, Kobe. And I wonder who's going to come out on top right now. It looks like the Team 8 HP bars are on top. Dominate's going to try to end the fight, hitting up Cali. That kind of kills out his damage if they can keep that snowball on him. But it looks like
Kwass,
just coming back up, is about to go back down. Another nail in the coffin coming in for teammate. And now they're going to get Dominate as he puts himself in, getting a kill for himself for the retribution, but still goes down to Cali. 4-0-1.
And 0
yeah.
Cali Trolls on the Aurelia. Also, he didn't have to use his teleport before getting the outer turret. So he got the turret, bought the home guards, teleported in, and made the play down bottom. This is the teammate that we talked up at the beginning of the year. Cali Trolls from the top lane, creating plays for the rest of the team. Slushy, as we see, just mad farming.
I thought it was going to take him a little bit to get here on the teleport, but he's here instantly.
Yeah, so he got the home guards on his back. Now, this was actually really well played. By Team Liquid and decent by Team 8 because they didn't know that Thresh was there. So good escape. Here's the turn, though. They don't expect the home guard Aurelia. You can see the teleport channeling right now. He comes all the way down from rafters. And so even though Kwass is there, which is what triggered Team Liquid to go for the re-engage for Expecial to actually go for that hook, it has equalized very quickly by that teleport disadvantage. They didn't keep track of the teleport from Cali or didn't think that there were deep enough wards from teammate to pull it off.
Well, good hits by teammate, but now they're being pressured quite hard in the mid lane. Phoenix dives right in. They throw Ignite down as well. Slushy will get hit up. Somehow they pull him out of the fire alive. New snakeskin for him.
He's allowed to go for that move because they see Cali top. They're like, you know what? He just teleported
Holy moly.
There's no way that Cali's going to come into this fight. Make it happen right now. Cali's the one with all the gold. He's the Fed member on the team. Let's fight them while he's not there. Exactly what Porpus was talking about in his little feature before the game. Yep. If somebody is extremely strong in League of Legends, you try and fight away on the other side of the map from them. Good job by Team Liquid forcing that. Wow, Cali was top, and they grab the turret answer on top of the double kill.
Definitely a fight they needed. You can see Cali is about 2,500 gold ahead of his laner. Not really helping out too much there. They are going to be able to go back, possibly get this dragon. They are looking at the mini map. They have no contest coming in from Team Liquid. They start getting some wards on the Baron as Dragon just goes down. You can see the pings up there as everybody's trying to get their own control of Crab. And the jaw. I laughed at him. Dang. The BM is real this
if
week.
You, well, you're allowed to do that if you steal anything jungle related from Nunu, especially as a top laner without Smite.
Okay, yeah, okay.
It's allowed to
that
go
makes
for
sense.
It. Dominant had just gotten a crab cake, though. Took a bite out of it. Little bit too low.
So where are we at in spike items? Looking in the mid lane as we see Phoenix and Slushy. Did get that Will of the Ancients on top of his Spirit Visage, so he's some crazy sustain now from that Spell Vamp, as well as a bit more AP to finally start doing some damage, but that Saracen Wraith is already finished on Phoenix.
Yeah, you know what's curious for me? The sort of selfish build from Porpoise, instead of going for Magic Resist Aura for the whole
just
team,
the Aegis, yeah.
He's going for his own personal Magic Resist. So he's going to be able to go on the front line here, but there's all this flat reduction and flat penetration in the Rumble and Cassiopeia builds. That's scary for the rest of his team.
Yeah.
If his squishies do not build their own Magic Resist, all this flat reduction and flat penetration is really going to pay off. Quas can have... Uh-oh. Yeah, you're going to want to run away from that one.
Oh, the pain is real. Having to use Absolute Zero to keep Piglet safe. Kali Trolls cannot contest that Do-si-do. There's the ultimate. The Glacial Prison locking up Expecial. Dominate just makes it out with a sliver of HP, and the chase may be here. Phoenix coming across the side, and the team knows it. They want to try to cut him off. And it looks like they may be able to pick that up now that he... I thought he was going to get pinched in by Dota or Slushy as well with that turret health being so low.
Yeah.
I mean, I don't see why they wouldn't.
You got to be careful about setting up those brush attacks.
Yeah.
Oh, Phoenix is
making a kill out of it. Nobody's got turret damage going down just yet. Whoa, Quas comes in. He's now in a 3v1 situation, forced to flash. And the team is still trying to fight Kali Trolls on the top side of the map as Piglet goes at it with him for a second. That turret's already taken a lot of damage. And Team 8 is just making some moves right now. A lot of just high abilities, ultimates, flashes, and summoners are needed to stop this from happening from Team 8.
Yeah, really taking advantage of the lack of organization
right
on Team Liquid. They set up this sort of one-man AD carry ambush in the top lane, and Expecial, you know, Dominate loses most of his elf bar, and Expecial ends up going down for those sins on the chase, and Team 8 pretty much just capitalizing on some wonky plays here from Team Liquid. Phoenix then staying by the very low health turret, and Quas, pretty much all of Team Liquid are in panic mode, trying to save members of the team that have been caught.
Definitely different from their fights yesterday when they could force fights on their own terms. Quas would always be there when his bar was about to hit on Gnar, or they could possibly take a fight. Here, a lot of that is the disengage. They're using Piglet's ultimate to make sure they're safe in these fights and not being the ones engaging. So trying to bring a team fight comp to teammates' team fight comp isn't working out yet.
As a result of the sort of split decisions from Team Liquid, teammate a fairly substantial lead now, and they can actually use this time to get down their deeper ring of vision so that they can do things like bait neutral objectives. A little bit early for Baron because that does a significant amount of damage at the point. At this point, but they do have a very strong split pusher. This is basically just what teammate want. They've got an Aurelia who's already fed and has teleport up. All they have to do is create that pressure on the bottom side, slowly gain advantages.
213 and now to 205 for the 80 carries. Maple Street is up to his Phantom Dancer, using that true get grit, I guess, for his own magic resistance. Hasn't built any yet. not too afraid of it. It'll be one of his last items. But right now, Kali Troll is trying to go a little hard. Quas hiding in the brush here. They may still be able to take down Quas. And Piglet, there's just too much tank on the other side right now. The bouncing could actually kill someone, Ricochet rather, but it does not. And just at the last second, they get help from another member. Team 8 is coming up really big on these plays that Team Liquid is almost forced to tunnel into to start to get
summoners
themselves back in. Slushy turning Dominate and Phoenix away with the Hemo Plague, knowing the team's coming up from the bottom. They didn't know how close they were on the side of Team Liquid. Oh boy, it just does not stop. Fights going coast to coast all the time, every second of this game. Absolute Zero separating what they need in the fight. Dominate gets dredge lined out onto Phoenix. Kali Trolls flashes, but he's still gonna go down to the turret aggro. Dominate is onto Slushy. One more flash, Snowball tries to get it in range. Now the Transfuse saves him from an Ignite, stopping him. Wow. Double kill still coming in for Phoenix, but back and forth. Team 8 is not afraid to keep the fights going this game.
Yeah, I feel like that was a Cali call. We've seen sometimes he gets, once he gets this fed, you really just, you get into that overdrive mode where you constantly want to make plays. And he was just reaching a little bit far with this one. Teleport, they didn't have a real vision on the rest of Team Liquid. Phoenix still had his ult for the counter engage, and then going to take turret shots is just really overestimating his power at this point. The rest of the team does end up paying for it because they were just on recall timers. Remember how low MapleStreet got in that bottom skirmish? There's no way he could help with this.
No.
So definitely overreaching there for Team 8. And Team Liquid get one step, another foot back into this game.
Yeah. See where they can go from here. Good items being built up on Phoenix. If he can stay alive a little bit longer in that mid lane, he now has a quick silver sash to do so if he's jumped on by Cali trolls at all. That, it pretty much porpoise, but he shouldn't be in range for that at the beginning of the fight. We'll see. It's going to be tough. Teammate has a lot to get these fights started, and Cali Trolls usually doesn't care. He'll just start the fight.
Look at that respect from Teammate for the new Cassiopeia ability to burn down Baron. They pull off of Dragon just because a couple members of Team Liquid are up there, and they barely have vision. You have to be very careful always against Dominate. He really likes going for those early neutrals. And Teammate, they're able to chase him off and then return to the Dragon to clean it up. So. Safe play there, and Teammate are able to secure the neutral.
Not too much pressure being put on the Dragons just yet. We're only at 3 total in the game. 2 for Teammate, 1 for Liquid. These things are going to start slowing down with Cali Trolls going back to the side lanes here. We'll see what the 4 members of Teammate can start to do as a group.
Ah, and the reason why Porpoise was going with his more selfish magic resist build is because he's got Dodo rushing the Aegis. He's got the magic resist aura for the team. So Locket already completed for Teammate. That is going to be really big for them. Bunch of magic resist for everybody. Going to help out with the flat pen builds.
Been everywhere, pulling up the dredge lines to get the kills, so why not? The game started to flow perfectly in that kind of favor for them to buy items. Now we'll see if they come into play exactly how they want. Not really been any flanks, just straight up fights. Cali Trolls catching somebody out in a brush. A few of the previous fights were Team Liquid thinking they could take what looked like one member of Teammate, but it then became 3 or 4 members as soon as we have Cali Trolls teleporting in and Dodo coming in on his mobility boots. So slowing it down here for Team Liquid, making sure that Quas has Cali Trolls. Maybe they can get a good fight out of Phoenix and the rest of the team in mid lane.
Yeah, that's a really good point. The Wombo from Team Liquid still packs a lot of punch, even though they have Magic Resist Aura.
Yeah.
If you stack a good equalizer on, you know, a Petrifying Gaze on the back line, Team Liquid do have a fairly strong combo they can pull off. Definitely advantage for Team 8, though, and they have to control the vision. That's all you really need to do in these teamfight versus teamfight matchups. If they can do a good enough job of sweeping through the jungle, lining the corridor with wards, and they will be in a very good position. Slushy first to level 16 right there for the Vladimir, and a little bit of the Baron bait.
Like we said, it Maple may get some magic resistance last, but he actually gets some now, and then a little bit more even for Porpoise. They're really adding on to synergize with that Locket.
They have not sniffed out that one ward.
It's a good place. I think it's like one of those wards you place where like this probably won't be sweet.
Oh, he's got the Oracle Lens upgrade. Does he see it?
Up. Team!
He saw it.
Team up! They're on to a special. That's a pretty good engage, but that's a choke point. I'm sure TSM will remember this one. Slushy's getting hit up now. It looks like Teammate's able to break that choke point before Team Liquid was able to do enough damage, though. Cali Trolls back and forth onto a special. Actually uses that as his exit now. Special almost gets ticked down there as Piglet comes up big with the ricochets and a huge front line, keeping him safe in the fight.
Ooh, Quas going to be careful here. Cali loves the one versus one. Not going to happen this time, though.
Hold
all right,
breath.
So this is going to mean, you know, control of the map here for the time being for Team Liquid. Since they're AD carry at full life, too, they might be able to grab an objective on top of it. Very big win there. The corridors. You were just talking about it, Rib. The Cassiopeia and the Rumble inside one of those jungle corridors. And they pull off an upset for the team fight. Also, what helped Team Liquid there is that their frontline. Oh. Kali's got his eyes set on the AD carry here. Doesn't really want to mess around with Xspecial.
Oh.
Does he? All right, goes for the support kill instead.
Got him, coach. All right, so flash teleport used there. Kali Trolls actually can't engage on too much more now. Maybe that's because they're going to force the Baron?
I mean,
no. That's kind of been what he's using to get in.
I'd say go all or nothing on the AD carry there, because if you get that support kill, you burn your flash for your support kill there without, you know, Dragon being up. But if you get the AD carry kill.
Oh, hello.
Oh, and he doesn't kill your support.
Oh, the RNG gods not looking upon Piglet for that last auto attack. Could be getting Kali Trolls, though. Great spell shield. He did like a no-look there on the dredge line. Picks himself up a double kill. And now they're on to Slushy, letting the tank walk around. Perfect micro by Liquid in that fight.
Whoa, things go from bad to worse for Team 8 here. Team Liquid might be able to burn down that Baron. Half mana on Phoenix. They've got the DPS. Do they have the confidence, though? Porpoise has the Sejuani ultimate ready. Maple Street is alive. If there's a two-man squad that can pull this stop off, then these are the two to do it.
Just giving the jungler a little bit of hell here, Kobe. Put him in the box. Make sure
happen.
He can't get to Baron. And now he's going to pay for this little roundabout with his life. Porpoise goes down, trying to get vision, trying to get a timer. I don't know, just being in the wrong place.
Oh, how quickly the tides turn here with one bad team fight. Let's walk down memory lane, back to that fight in the jungle corridor. You run through the small space. So this is Piglet. You killed my support. You left Piglet alive, so he's going to take vengeance for his support. Take down Dodo and a really good zone there from Dominate setup so that Kali took the majority of his health bar just walking away through the slow field. And then very easy for Team Liquid to clean up because all of their DPS is there ready to capitalize on the zoning from Dominate. That's the other thing. So I was just about to go back to the very first team fight in that area.
Right.
Where Team 8, they filed not only through this corridor for the Rumble and Cassiopeia, but they also focused a lot of their early damage into the Nunu and the Thresh. Their target selection was not helping them out in that team fight because both Kali and Maple Street overcommitted for very low priority targets. Maple Street flashed in or committed so far in to try and kill Xspecial, they had to flash out and then die to Piglet on the exit. That's just a Thresh. Meanwhile, Kali dumped a lot of damage into the Nunu, I Will Dominate, which is exactly what he wants as well. So pretty much the perfect fight there in the jungle for Team Liquid to get them right back in this game. Now they've got Baron buff, they can easily siege up and knock down a bunch of turrets.
And without getting pretty close to the waves, Team 8 does not have a whole bunch of wave clear. So it's going to be difficult. Got Graves right up on the turret there, and you can see already Dominate walks up. Graves has to walk backwards, or Maple Street rather, and it's tough. Maybe the pinch here of the base getting choked in will give them a little bit more defensive. I don't know. Doesn't look like Team Liquid wants it all. They're definitely going to get a split push here with Quas towards the top side. They know they're stronger with this bit of combo here in the bot lane. So drop a few turrets and at least get it closer around the map. Right now they can only go from mid to bottom. Doesn't work too well.
Yeah.
So they're going to slow things down.
That power spike of the
or not
super fed Aurelia is waning very quickly here. She only sits on the one damage item, the Trinity Force, and just tries to build more tanky after that. He's got the Guardian Angel active ready, so at least he's got the Guardian Angel proc for this team fight, which will be crucial. Frozen Heart also completed. His whole goal is to get in there, force the teleport from Quas without getting stuck. But they haven't been able to force a teleport, so they're losing turrets on the top side. Team Liquid split push paying off.
Quas without wards. He could actually get taken down in this situation. He's being very patient, though, keeping his gauge up, making sure he does the most amount of damage.
Kali going for the 1v1 up there.
Yep. So that's going to be the 1v1. Does Team 8 as well on the other side of the map go for any type of engage? Doesn't look like it. Slushy is on the fountain for the time being, but they do save that second tier turret.
Yeah.
Just a game of waiting right now. Teammate waiting for that mistake. And actually the teleport coming in, that's gonna be back as well from Kali Trolls. He's gonna be coming home guard off the fountain. They've lost the inhibitor turret. Dredge line goes out, it hits Phoenix. It looks like they get a quick Iron Solarion to mitigate any of that damage.
Back out, no inhibitor down, but they did at least open the doors for Team Liquid.
Yeah.
teleport going to be available for Cali, and they will have the advantage in that area. Still does have Guardian Angel, but as we saw before, Quas just needs to land his double slow, and he can walk away from the fight.
Things just got a little bit easier for the carries on Liquid as well, with that Mikhail's coming up in the hands of Xspecial. Phoenix won't have to use a Quicksilver Sash as much anymore to get himself to safety. See gold 14.7 to 11.8 in that mid lane. We saw Phoenix going pretty hard. 13.9 to 12.7 for Cali and Quas. And you can see that Quas has really closed that gold gap that Cali had in the beginning. Like you said, Cali falling off a bit. And something we did mention in the beginning, Kobe, is was the teams would kind of falter or fall behind in the mid in the early part of the game. But the mid-game team fights we see where everybody like Team Liquid, who placed third last year, has a little more communication there, starts to come back in the game.
Yeah, the Team Liquid team comp, very unforgiving. If you make these big teamfight mistakes against a squad that has very, very high DPS double AP with a blood-boiled 80 carry, really, really hard to pull it back.
Let's see what they can do here. As they gauge teammate coming straight in. Like we said, Cali Trolls, it would just be the forward dive if they try to do any type of engage. And Slushy now on the front line. Collateral damage already comes out from Maple Street, not doing too much damage. Looks like Liquid can re-enter this fight perfectly. And they're going to start melting down teammate here. A flash over the wall. Cali tries to teleport out. Looks like he will actually make it. The play! It ticked him against the wall. It did tag him. And he's going to go down in the end. These are now 40-second timers that they're going to have to come back from. And you already have Piglet and Phoenix rushing down the mid lane with Quas. Cali will eventually go down, but he's fighting valiantly. He's making it work.
Special, you monster. Cali with the very quick flash to avoid hook and then immediate teleport channel. But Xspecial's got him covered with the ward over the wall into the max range play.
Yeah. That's all that Team Liquid was waiting for. When Team 8 would get too confident and put themselves in the choke point, Liquid again wanted to fight it. Right down that mid lane, they pushed them off to the side. And another inhibitor turret, an inhibitor for them as they back out of teammate's base. Looks like it's only going to be a few more minutes before they do it again.
All right, so the initial dive here from Team 8, if everybody goes for it, they've got Team Liquid separated. But you don't have much time because Sivir pops her ultimate right now. Is it going to arrive at the fight? Dominate channels his ultimate to try and keep teammate grouped up there. And boom, Piglet's here. Everybody's in the flame spitter, roasting as the boomerang blade and bouncing blades chop them all up. And then here it is. Xspecial wards walks right up to the edge of the wall. The very, very end of that play has to have tagged him.
Is either the flare or the tick of the ignite to hit?
Well, the tick of the ignite doesn't stop.
Oh, you're right. You're
teleport.
Right. You're right.
Yeah, because it was a yeah.
Dang, Xspecial.
You gotta walk all the way up and just hug that wall too.
Well, all right, made it happen. See what Liquid can do here as they get the Baron. It does not look contested. That goes down once again. Team 8 is going to have to sit in their base. Hopefully the trapdoor for them is big enough to fit the entire team of Team Liquid in for their group up, for their Glacial Prison, and then Hemo Plague, hopefully collateral damage. It's not as much AoE that's gonna hurt with that collateral being more of an execute, but hopefully they can really get something to start the fight and work it.
Piglet just checking the brush with his blade. No sound, nobody in there, and they just move right on up. Collect the last inhibitor. Here it is, last fight for teammate.
There's the flank though. Porpoise gets a beautiful Glacial Prison. Can they organize the team fight though? Already, they're gonna get Cali Trolls going down, one of the big damage dealers. The DPS coming out of Phoenix is almost unstoppable right now. And the second kill, or double kill I should say, is going to be coming in for Quas. Loose Slushy on the backside was able to do quite a bit of damage to Dominate and Phoenix. And it looks like Liquid is going to have to reassess this fight now. We do have Piglet in the middle trying to clear the minions towards the Nexus turrets, and Porpoise can't do much about it.
Nope, he's going to take some damage and have to run for his life. All right, they chase him out of his own base. That should be game then. Nexus turrets under fire.
Should very much indeed be game. Porpoise trying with the team at one last attempt. A great Glacial Prison engage, but Team Liquid was able to walk around it, figure it out, and pass the test. Slushy puts on the Zhonyas as the Nexus goes down. He will go as well. 41-18 on the clock, and Team Liquid take down Team 8. A little scary in the beginning for Liquid.
Well, a lot of back and forth. A couple of questionable team calls from both sides. And Team Liquid, once they get that final burst of gold there, that one good team fight close to the Baron, able to take control.
1, 2, 3, Team Liquid!
Team 8 with very strong early game. A lot of the times we saw them fighting, it would be kind of around a turret that was already falling, so that's the turret they got, and then they kind of wouldn't get more out of it. They'd always almost pause after fights. Didn't have the waves to push up more, didn't have everything at that time in the game. The fights were great, the timings of those, and the kills they were allowed to get as well. It probably made Team Liquid fall on the back foot for quite some time, but the strategies were there. All it took was Team 8 walking into the jungle, and Liquid was patient enough for that to happen. That's one big thing as well.
Yeah, what a good early game from Cali, able to get to his Trinity Force on time, use his Trinity Force right as soon as he got it. Pretty much 30 seconds after, gets his solo kill on Quas, burns the flash, gets the tower. He knows it. Ooh. He had control of the game. Such an good early start, but you can't make too many mistakes in the LCS. Expect to take home the victory.
Looking through these as well. And maybe playing a little harder on him as well. You know, he takes it to himself that a few of the calls throughout the last split as well were maybe a little too overzealous. He got the team into trouble sometimes. And that on that last play could have been it. They were taking that second tier turret down and they dove onto the steps. That was the fight Team Liquid was able to flank them on and that they were looking for. So maybe once again, a little too overzealous in the play. The team was on board though, and that's still a good thing to see, is that everybody is following those calls.
Sometimes Team Liquid here.
They just don't work out.
Second victory for them.
Absolutely.
Feeling very good about themselves in the opening week.
Hey, it's not too crazy, man. Don't take it crazy. Like Dominic
they
said
did,
last
You're
time.
Right. They did start out last split with a 2-0 as well.
So Dominic, it'll be hitting all the naysayers on Twitter. It's like, you guys 2-0 again. We're like, no, it's all right. But still,
yeah. Control expectations.
They deserved it. Definitely an early game for them to look at. The first time they lost the early game, I think it was just coming out, obviously not respecting the team they were playing against at the time with subs and whatnot. And then you see the second game, still a little bit early game falter. But when it comes to the communication, they're much more on board with Piglet now, and the fights are happening way different than they did in the spring split for Team Liquid. Crazy, crazy stuff. Hopefully they can do more or better throughout the season. For more on the 2-0 start, let's send it down to Chat, who is standing.